Here at KiwiCo, we love answering awesome questions from kids. Today, we have a really interesting one from Beckett.
I saw a dog walking around in the neighborhood with three legs. It was getting around just fine. But I was wondering if dogs ever get replacement legs like humans do.
I know, it's really cool to see those replacement legs, arms, or other parts for humans. Those are called prosthetics. And since the first known one, a wooden toe found on an Egyptian mummy, prosthetics have changed a lot to make them more comfortable and a lot easier to use. They're now bionic, they can be controlled by muscles, and they can be helpful for specific things that the user wants to do, like run or jump. And so while I know a little about human prosthetics, I don't know anything about ones for dogs and other animals, but I do know someone who might. We can give Derrick Campana a call. He's the founder of Bionic Pets and the host of a TV show called Wizard of Paws.
Hi, Derrick. It's so good to meet you.
How's it going?
One of the kids in our community was curious about prosthetics for dogs. What you do with your team to help animals is super interesting and inspiring, and so we're really looking forward to learning more.
Yeah, it's really cool. We travel all over the world helping all different types of animals in need. Prosthetics, orthotics, carts, you name it, we can build it.
So orthotics and prosthetics, can you help me understand the difference?
I always say orthotics brace, prosthetics replace.
Oh, that's really interesting. So with orthotics, braces are used to help give extra support to the leg.
Yes.
And with prosthetics, these take the place of a missing leg.
Yep.
So what kinds of animals have you helped?
Yeah, so I've helped so many animals to this point. Elephants, guinea pigs, sheep, llamas, deer, even emus, alpacas, and things like that.
Oh my gosh, I didn't realize you've helped so many different kinds of animals. By any chance, do you know how many animals you've helped?
I've probably helped between 35 and 40,000 animals to date.
That's amazing.
What's really cool is we can treat all animals around the world from afar in our one lab here in Sterling, Virginia. So, like I said, any size, big or small, because we can help almost any animal anywhere.
Wow, so you do all of that from your lab?
So initially we send a casting kit out and people will take a negative mold of the leg. They'll ship it here. We'll fill that with plaster of Paris and make a positive mold. From there, I'll hand sculpt it. I do everything by hand. This is more of an art than a science, I tell everybody. So after that, we'll vacuum form foams and plastics over it. We'll cut it out, grind it out, add componentry and straps, and then we'll fit it to the animal.
Okay, so once you fit it on the animal, how does the animal know what to do?
Animals react to these devices in all different ways. There are different ways to get animals used to and adjusted to these devices, but that initial reaction is always really fun to watch because you're not sure what's gonna happen.
That's amazing. It must be so rewarding to see animals with their new parts that you've made. Thank you so much for your time, and thanks so much for helping to answer Beckett's question.
Thank you guys so much for having me, and I hope this helps spread the word.
Wow, that was so interesting. Who knew animals could get a second chance to move and play? And it's because Derrick and his team make orthotics and prosthetics for animals all over the world. I still can't believe he's helped around 40,000 animals. That is awesome and so cool to see. All right, keep asking great questions like Beckett did. If you'd like to see more videos like this, like and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time.